sometimes the id and superego are fighting a lot, and that is creating a lot of internal conflict, that is creating a lot of anxiety. So sometimes ego uses certain mechanisms so that the anxiety does not get built up to a very high level. So these mechanisms are called as defense mechanisms. They help in preventing the buildup of excessive anxiety. And most of these defense mechanisms, in fact, all of these defense mechanisms but one, are unconscious. When we use defense mechanisms, we don't even realize that we are using a defense mechanism. So let's talk about defense mechanisms. Now, defense mechanisms have been divided into four groups. The only way of remembering a defense mechanism is remembering the example. So let's talk about the first group. The first group is narcissistic defense mechanisms. And the first of these is denial. Now, denial is basically a refusal to accept the reality. For example, say a mother was washing clothes and suddenly the news came that the five-year-old son of this mother fell down from the roof and died. Mother responded, nothing. Mother heard the news, she did not say anything, and she continued washing clothes as if nothing has happened. So what really happened here? The mother was washing the clothes, the news of the son falling down and dying came to her. Now mother's ego immediately understood that mother would not be able to accept this news. This news would create so much anxiety that she would not be able to tolerate it. So what did the ego do? Ego took out the defense mechanism of denial and it kind of stopped the news. Mother refused to believe in the news. So later on when mother is in that situation, the news would be allowed to come in and mother would react appropriately. This is denial, refusal to accept that anything has happened. Second is projection. Projection is transfer of feelings about a person on to that person. What does it mean? Say there is a husband and there is a wife. Now the husband wants to cheat on wife. Husband wants to have an affair. But the moment this thought came that he wants to have an affair, the superego of the husband became very angry, because superego is against all these things. Superego works on morality principle. It, on the other hand, wants to have fun. So there's a fight going on between id and superego. The anxiety is building up. Finally, what ego does is it uses projection. It says that I don't want to have an affair. The husband says that he does not want to have an affair. He says that actually wife wants to have an affair. And because she wants to have an affair, if I also have an affair, that is fine. So what the husband did, whatever feeling he had for the wife, he kind of transferred that onto the wife. He said she wants to have an affair when in reality he wanted to have an affair. This is projection. It is involved in the development of delusions and hallucinations. Now let's talk about the second group. We are talking about the immature defense mechanisms now, after narcissistic defenses. The first one is acting out. What is acting out? Acting on an unconscious desire without becoming aware of it. So for example, say a person had an unconscious desire of stealing. He wants to steal. Now the problem is, if this desire, which is unconscious as of now, if it reaches the conscious mind, the person will start feeling guilty. So what will happen? This person might go into a mall and suddenly, without even thinking, he would steal something and would put in the pocket. Say he stole a pen and put it in the pocket. What happened? That desire that wanted to come out was able to come out, giving relief to the person. And because he did not became aware of it, he did not even feel guilty at that time. Later on, he might feel guilty, but at that time, he did not feel guilty. This is what happens in impulse control disorders. This is impulse control disorder defense mechanism. The next one is passive aggressive. Here there is expression of feelings in an indirect way. For example, you ask your younger brother to get you a glass of water. The younger brother does not want to bring you a glass of water, but he is not able to say no directly. So what he does, he goes to the kitchen, gets a glass of water, but while coming to your room, he accidentally falls down and the water also falls down on the ground. So what has happened? He has taken his revenge. And he did not even have to say it directly to you. The problem is, or the interesting fact is, even the brother does not know that why did he fell down. Even the brother did not know that. He was basically trying to prove a point indirectly. Defense mechanisms are unconscious. The next is regression. Return to an earlier stage of development seen in neurosis. So, for example, you have been studying for an exam. You are very tired and very frustrated. So, you are going back from library to your room. Suddenly, you see that there are small kids, children playing in the park. You throw away your books and copies. You join them and you play with them for the next 3 hours. What you are trying to do? For 3 hours, you are trying to go back to that stage of your life when life was simple. When you did not have to appear for an entrance examination, you were regressing. If it happens too much and to a great extent, then neurosis may develop. Now, this one is a difficult one, projective identification, usually seen in patients with borderline personality disorder. Now, here what happens is intolerable aspects of self are projected onto another person, and person is induced to behave in a particular fashion, and that creates a system. For example, say there is a wife and there is a husband. Now, wife is having some aggressive impulses. What she does is, she would project it to the husband. She would do something to make the husband behave in an aggressive manner. And now what will happen? Husband is aggressive, wife is the recipient of that aggression, and a system has developed where aggression is being manifested. So, this is projective identification seen in borderline personality disorder patients. Let's talk about the third group, which is neurotic defenses. The first of these is displacement, transfer of emotions from one individual to another, which is involved in phobias. For example, you go back home, your father scolds you really bad because of some reason. You are very angry, but you can't do anything. So what you do instead is, you go into the room of your younger brother and you start beating him. What are you doing? You are displacing your anger from father to the younger brother, who is a softer target, involved in the development of phobias. Repression. You forget something and you are not able to access it. For example, that what happened in that girl who was sexually abused, one fine day, her memory, the memory of sexual abuse got repressed, got hidden in the unconscious mind, and now she can't access it. That is repression. Rationalization. Giving a logical reason for an unacceptable behavior. For example, you ask an alcoholic, why do you drink so much? He says, there is so much pain and anguish in my life that if I don't drink, I will die. He is trying to give a logical reason for his unacceptable behavior, quite commonly seen in patients with substance use disorders. Reaction formation. Transforming an impulse into its exact opposite behavior. For example, say Valentine's Day is coming and you desperately want to go out on a date, but forget about date, no girl is ready to even talk to you. So what you do? You join a group and you say Valentine's Day is against the Indian culture, and you start beating those couples who are going out on a date. You are using reaction formation. Intellectualization. Where there is an excessive use of intellect to avoid the painful emotions. For example, say a doctor is diagnosed with pancreatic cancer, and when the surgeon comes to meet him, rather than talking about anything else, he starts talking about the pathophysiology of carcinoma. What the doctor is doing is, he is using an excessive intellectual process to hide the emotion of pain, which is there because of being diagnosed with a cancer. Isolation of affect. You remove the affect, you remove the feeling associated with a stressful event. For example, say a female was diagnosed with, say, breast cancer. She was told that she has breast cancer. She comes back home and, as a matter of fact, without saying and without expressing any emotion, tells this to the family members that she has been diagnosed with breast cancer without showing any emotion at all. So, she has stated the fact but removed the emotion that should have been associated with that fact. Undoing. An act is done to nullify the previous event, usually seen in patients with obsessive compulsive disorder. Okay, please remember, all these defense mechanisms can be seen in normal people also, right? All of them can be seen in normal people also. Only when they are used extensively and beyond a certain limit they are considered abnormal. So undoing is an act is done to nullify the previous act. So for example, say a husband and wife had a fight and husband said something mean to the wife. Next day he brings a gift for the wife. So he's trying to undo the behavior of the last day. Aim inhibition. Aim inhibition is an aim is limited and partial fulfillment is accepted. For example, say there's a person who wanted to become a doctor and he appeared for PMT pre-medical test for 4 years but could not clear it. So he was not able to become a doctor. So what he does now? He now goes for a bridge course. He now goes for a bridge course and becomes that other doctor. So he was not able to fulfill his ambition completely. So he settled down for something lesser, bridge course. Finally, let's talk about the mature defense mechanisms. The mnemonic goes as SAHAS, S-A-H-A-S. The first one is sublimation, transformation of a socially unacceptable impulse into a socially acceptable behavior. It should be behavior. Transformation of a socially unacceptable impulse into a socially acceptable behavior. For example, say you are a person who has got a lot of aggression. You have a lot of aggressive impulses. You like blood, you like flesh, you like violence. Now, all this would be considered as socially unacceptable. So, what do you do now? You become a surgeon. When you become a surgeon, you can play with the blood and flesh, and it would also be considered as a socially acceptable behavior. Preparing in advance for an unpleasant situation. For example, you have made a mistake and you know that you will go back home and your father will scold you, shout at you. So you make a plan that if father says this, I will reply with this. And if father brings this point out, I will throw this point. So you prepare in advance for the upcoming argument. Anticipation. In fact, you are preparing right now. You are again using anticipation. You are trying to avoid the unpleasant situation of not being selected. Humor. Use of comedy to deal with an unpleasant situation. For example, you go for viva, and in the viva, the internal as well as the external examiner get together and humiliate you, embarrass you. You get out of the room, you look at your best friend, and both of you start laughing. What are you doing? You are trying to laugh to kind of hide your own embarrassment. This is humor. Mature defense mechanism. Altruism. Use of a social cause to deal with your own emotions. Say a father was driving a car in a drunk state and sitting on the passenger seat was his son. The car met an accident and the son died. 6 months later, father starts a social campaign where he goes from society to society and tells about the ills of drunk driving. Now it looks like that he is doing a social thing, but in reality, he is dealing with his own guilt. And lastly comes the suppression. In suppression, you forget something, but that something which you have forgotten can be easily brought back. For example, you are frustrated with your life and you say that for 24 hours, I will forget that I have any exam to appear in. Not to say you have forgotten something, but it is there in the back of your mind. Whenever you feel like, you can bring that memory back. So all defense mechanisms are unconscious except suppression. Suppression is a conscious defense mechanism or a voluntarily used defense mechanism. So this was about defenses.